As a follow-up to the main video about how quantum computers factor large numbers to break encryption, I want to demonstrate how Shor's algorithm would factor a real live number. Like maybe you were bequeathed a bank vault full of pies, but the access code left to you was encrypted using the number 314,191, and you can't get to the pies until you know the factors. Luckily, I happen to have a working quantum computer that can run Shor's algorithm. As a refresher, here's a rough overview of how Shor's algorithm factors large numbers quickly. For any crappy guess at a number that shares factors with n, that guess to the power p over 2 plus or minus 1 is a much, much better guess, if we can find p. And we can find p almost immediately with a single, if complex, quantum computation. So first we make some random crappy guess, like, I don't know, 101? Then we check to see if 101 shares a factor with 314,191, and it doesn't. So our goal is to find the special power p, for which 101 to the p over 2 plus or minus 1 is a better guess for a number that shares factors with 314,191. To do this, we need to find the number p such that 101 to the p is one more than a multiple of 314,191. This is where we use my quantum computer, which can raise 101 to any power, and calculate how much more that power is than a multiple of 314,191. If we start with a superposition of all the numbers up to 314,191, then the quantum computation will give us the superposition of 101 plus 101 squared plus 101 cubed, and so on, and then the superposition of the remainders. So we measure just the state of the remainders, and we'll get one remainder as an output, say 74,126, from which we know that the rest of the quantum state is left in a superposition of the possible powers that resulted in the remainder 74,126, which must all be p apart from each other. I explained why in the other video. Because we're not actually dealing with particularly big numbers, I've done the calculation and can tell you that this would mean we had a superposition of 20 and 4,367 and 8,714, and so on, and the difference between them is p. But in a real situation, we of course wouldn't know what the numbers in the superposition are. We just know that they're separated with a period of p, or a frequency of 1 over p. Though we still don't know what p is. The next step is to put the superposition through a quantum Fourier transform, which will pick out that frequency, and result in a superposition of 1 over p plus 2 over p plus 3 over p, and so on. This is a part I glossed over in the main video, but for technical reasons, the quantum Fourier transform doesn't just output 1 over p. It outputs a superposition of multiples of 1 over p. Anyway, again, because these are small numbers, I can tell you that we'd have a superposition of 1 over 4,347, and 2 over 4,347, and 3 over 4,347, and so on. But in practice, we wouldn't actually know what they were. So we measure the superposition, and we'd randomly get one of the values as the output. Say, for example, 5 over 4,347. And then we do the calculation again, and get, say, 6 over 4,347, and then 2 over 4,347, and so on. Pretty soon, we'd be able to tell that 1 over 4,347 is the common factor of all of those, and so p is 4,347. And you can check that 101 to the 4,347 is indeed exactly one more than a multiple of 314,191, though it's a very, very, very big multiple. So to get our better guess for a number that shares a factor with 314,191, let's take 101 to the power of 4,347 over 2 plus wait, crap. 4,347 is odd, so we can't divide it by 2 and get a whole number, so we have to start over. Sorry. Well, let's pick another random guess, say 127. After going through the same process of creating simultaneous superpositions of raising 127 to all possible powers, and then doing a quantum Fourier transform, and so on, we'd end up finding that the value of p corresponding to 127 is 17,388. And so raising 127 to p over 2 gives 127 to the 8,694, plus or minus 1, for our new and improved guess of a number that shares factors with 314,191. Using Euclid's algorithm on 314,191 with 127 to the 8,694 plus 1 gives a common factor of 829, and using it on 314,191 with 127 to the 8,694 minus 1 gives a common factor of 379. And 829 times 379 does indeed give us 314,191. So, now we can break the encryption, and you can have your pie. If you want to make sure your digital life is more secure than the bank vault in this video, then I highly recommend using a password manager to generate and securely store a long and unique password for each site and service you use. I myself have long used and highly recommend Dashlane, who are sponsoring this video. Dashlane has legitimately improved my online life. It generates and remembers a long, unique password for each of my internet accounts so I don't have to. It lets me know when my passwords are weak or when a site or app I use has been hacked. It securely stores, and with my permission, autofills my credit card, bank account, and address info on websites so I don't have to waste my time typing that stuff over and over. It lets me securely share passwords with family and coworkers, and on top of all that, Dashlane is a VPN, too. Dashlane is free for up to 50 passwords for as long as you like, so you should really just go to dashlane.com/minutephysics right now to check it out. And if you like Dashlane after trying it out, which I imagine you probably will, the first 200 people get 10% off Dashlane Premium by going to dashlane.com/minutephysics and using promo code minutephysics. Dashlane Premium gets you the VPN, unlimited storage and syncing of passwords, remote account access, and more. Again, that's dashlane.com/minutephysics with promo code minutephysics. Thanks to Dashlane for supporting Minute Physics and for simplifying and securing my online life.